Welcome to Savvy IT Solutions. Now we are explaining Java program using Notepad and command prompt. After installing Java, we need to set a path. Path can be set in two ways. One is temporary path setup and second one is permanent path setup. Okay, that is not discussed in this session. Why? Because we are moving to explaining the programming concept. So already we discussed the sample program. Same program I will write. So the class class is the keyword. It indicates that what we are writing next is called the class. So the class name is sample, and that is an identifier. Next one, public, it is a keyword. Static, it is a keyword. Void, main, string args. So here public is a keyword, it means that it can access anywhere in the project. Static is the reserved keyword, it means that without creating an object, the class will be executed with the help of the keyword static. Similarly, void means it is a data type, it returns nothing. Main, we are using symbolically, the programming starts execution with the main, so we are using main. So string is the data type, and args is the arguments, array of arguments of type string we are taking into consideration. So the next is curly bracket begins, and I am closing it. So here I am writing system dot out dot println welcome to Java. So here system is a class, out is an object. System is class, out is an object, and println method to display the message. After typing the program, we need to save this program. Click on save, means click on Ctrl S, and in the D I am creating the folder name is Java program. Under this I will save as same as class name, sample sample dot java, and here text documents it changed to all files, and save. Okay, after that we need to open command prompt and go to D drive. Okay, now we need to type move to Java programming, and now we need to compile the program with the help of Java C is the compiler to convert source code into bytecode. So Java C dot Java C space sample dot Java. If no errors, successfully compiled. If it is any error, it indicates with error. Now I am running the program. It's Java interpreter. Java sample, automatically you will get the output. Now everything is fine. Now what we are doing is I remove semicolon and try to compile the program. So it indicates error semicolon expected some line. So I will put semicolon here. Now I am moving double quotes. Unclosed string literal, it indicates unclosed string literals. Now instead of system S capital, I am putting small. It indicates an error, package system does not exist, small system does not exist. So I put capital S. Similarly, I replace with capital S with small s. Here also it indicate an error, that error cannot find symbol string. So like this we need to find different types of errors. Okay, and we need to successfully compile the program. So that is what exactly the sample program. Now I am discussing about data type program. I will take new notepad. The name of the class is data type dot java. Here we need to change all. So class data type. Similarly, public static void main string args. Under this, I am creating few data types, and simultaneously I need to print the what is the value it contains in the each and every variable. So first I am taking integer variable a is equal to some value. Similarly, byte b is equal to some value. Similarly, short c is equal to some value. Similarly, long d is equal to some, we need to assign some value. Similarly, float some variable is g is equal to 3.5f. While assigning a value to the float, we need to put f. Double f is equal to 345.6, and char k is equal to a boolean h is equal to false. Now I need to print these values. So I will copy this statement. Why? Because we need to write n number of times. So second one is byte b. Short c. Long d. Float f, sorry, float g. Double f. Character k. Now for boolean, if h is equal to true, we need to print boolean value true. Else boolean value false. Now I am saving this program. Now I am compiling this program. Java C data type dot Java. So I am using only 1T, but I am okay, sir. Nice, it's correct. So somewhere it indicates an error. So that is instead of equal to, I am using minus symbol. I will will get minus symbol. So I resolved it. Now again, double quotes is missing. Where exactly? System.out.println boolean value. So here double quotes are missing. Now it successfully compiled. Now while running this program, you will get the output. Thank you.